everybody, GamersDetection here, and welcome to a brand new walkthrough on the channel. A lot of people are gonna call it a Let's Play because it's like live commentary, but I tried doing it with Super Mario Galaxy 2 and Lego Indiana Jones 2 The Adventure Continues, and I realized that's not me, that's not who I am. And my thing is that, like, with Indiana Jones and the Staff of Kings, Lego Indiana Jones The Original Adventures, I can still have live commentary for a walkthrough, be informative about it, be fun about it, and still help you guys through the game. A lot of people say, no, a walkthrough must purely be informative, and you cannot have any fun doing it. No, I don't agree with that. I think that if I'm good enough at the game, I'm confident enough in the game, I can do a walkthrough for it. Things like Sister Location, that was a blind Let's Play. But, regardless, I'm going to stop rambling. In this walkthrough, I'll be showing you where all the collectibles are, all the chips, cookies are, get the secondary and primary objectives. So, without wasting any time, let's get into this.
So let me just push the eject button on the console, because obviously there's no... Since this is on a 6th generation console,
I have to push the eject button on the console itself in order to actually get it into the console, and I want to have time to do that little intro. Okay, so this is that, and I'll just let the quote-unquote intro roll through. Something else I didn't mention before that I guess I probably should have mentioned is that this is a reboot to a walkthrough I did about a year ago that I didn't finish. I stopped it around episode 7 or 8. I think it was 8, actually. And then I didn't continue it because I didn't have time to do it, and then I stopped doing it. But because I have so much nostalgia for this game, and I really, really want to get back into it and finish it, I decided to reboot it back up again, start it again. So, let's press start to begin. Let's just open up slot number 4 so that we can get into this, because I think you can only have 4 slots available at a time. Anyway. So let's just look at the extras really quickly, because you can get collectibles in-game that I'm showing you how to get. And you have concept art, movies, music, and original comics. You haven't unlocked any extras yet, so don't worry. That's going to change momentarily. So, let's just start a new game. And wait, let me just make sure really quickly to make sure that there are subtitles on. Yep, subtitles are indeed. Oh, actually, difficulty. Let's set it. Wait, wrong. Let's set the difficulty to hard, just so that I can set it at its max, so I can show you guys how to get through it. Alright, let's do this.
Maybe going inside a human's house wasn't such a good idea.
I want to eat! I want food!
Food is what you'll get, hamster. Enough food to fill a bear cave, hopefully. Okay, everyone, pay attention.
Oh, look at the light!
We need to get through the next 3 yards. Everyone knows your roles, right? Heather and I run along the front of the houses and come in through the basement window. At the first sign of trouble, we...
We resist the urge to faint, so we can warn everyone, right?
Oh, right.
Lou, Penny, you'll meet us at the house?
Just me. Penny will stay home with the little ones.
Oh, jeepers. I don't want you by yourself in a human house there.
But
we do this together.
Hamilton?
Where to go, huh?
You and Stella meet us at the hole in the fence in the 3rd yard, right?
Right. 3rd yard, yep. 3 comes after 6, right?
Stella?
Help Hammy count to 3. Got it.
And Verne and I will navigate the 3 yards full of the most devious human traps imaginable, sticking to the shadows like creatures of the night, sneaking past incredible dangers, and...
Sometime before the sun comes up would be good.
Right. Everyone ready?
Good luck, everyone, and be careful!
Alright, as you can see, there are primary goals and secondary goals.
Wow, I have to say, this doesn't look so bad.
Great, let's move out!
Secondary goals you do not have to get, but they're completely optional. But in order for you to actually get 100%, you need to complete all secondary goals. So let's go over the controls. This is available for the Xbox, PlayStation 2, GameCube, I think, PC. I know it's available for the PC. So I'm going to be doing it for the Xbox controls. A button to jump, use the left stick to move around. X button for attacking, and then if you hold down the B button, you can essentially do kind of a golf thing. This only really makes sense for RJ, because all the other characters have their own thing. Verne has a little bit of hockey stick, Hammy has an actual stick, and Stella has a plunger, I believe? Anyway, Y doesn't do anything at the moment, neither do right trigger and left trigger, but the black button is to switch characters if you're playing this as single player and not co-op, and then the white button doesn't do anything for the moment. So, in the starting area, there are some objects for you to break, and we're going to be breaking all of them just so that we can get all of the collectibles. You can't break this table, obviously, but you can break this can, and inside this little watering can is going to be your first cookies box. There are 20 cookie boxes for us to collect, not in total, but for now. And not in this level, don't worry, don't freak out over it. So the first thing you want to do is come around this corner, and you're going to hit this little spotlight right here, which will cue some dialogue once you pass a certain threshold.
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
What, breathe?
That too, but I meant stepping into the light. Looks like some kind of amphibian.
Wouldn't a turtle be less cliche?
Let's find ourselves a frog then. How hard could it be?
If you step into this thing, you're going to get electrocuted. But what we're going to do instead is we're going to head on to this little side deck right here. Break this chair for a chip and this chair. And then if we come back around onto this pool area, we're going to find yet another can of chips in the backhand corner of this pool. Though it looks more like a hot tub because based off how shallow it is. So then, continuing along this deck, I want to keep moving. The only thing, there's one major complaint I have about this game, and that's the camera angle. But because you can't really control where it is. Hop over those little AC units to enter this doghouse. Once again, the CD is completely optional to go and grab, but for 100% and completionists out there, you do need to go and grab the collectibles. So, there's another chip container inside that structure there, and then once you enter this area, it'll cue some dialogue.
Snap. Them, I predict. What gives, Chief? Who died and made you king of the picnic tables?
Poultry alert, pan out!
Alright. So, this is your first combat encounter of the game, and basically, it's a repetitive system of smacking the X button. Sometimes the combat can get a little bit more intense in later battles, but for this first one, you gotta continually smack the X button or whatever your attack button is until you can't attack them anymore, and then recharge, and then attack them again. Chips in this structure, a little soda can in this structure, there are cookies in this structure, or sorry, this little potted plant, another soda can right here, and then there's nothing really interesting. Well, there are two pizzas right here, but those just fill up your food or your hunger bars, I should say. Because what food does to this game, like you can get chips and pizza and the like, they fill up those blue dots at the top or green dots if you're Verne, or orange dots if you're Hammy, or purple dots if you're Squillo, and that's your health basically, as represented by the heart. And then that little meter at the bottom is what I'm about to show right here. If you hold down the Y, you do a little bit of a spin attack, and this is essentially your super move. So that's kind of cool. And one of our secondary objectives is to open two coolers. That's the first of two coolers located throughout this level. So once you've done that, go and grab the statue of this frog and place it onto the slab. That's our objective completed. Nothing else hidden in this area. So let's head on to the next one.
Wahoo there! Think you're just waltzing through this gate like a couple of gate waltzers? You both have a lot to learn about birds, don't ya? Don't ya?
You don't want a piece of me, Tweety. Seriously.
You wouldn't want to see my friend here bluster and fume, would you?
Look, people, I don't make the rules. You want into the next yard, you need my help. Sorry, guys. City ordinance. We're all slaves to bureaucracy. That's what separates us from the humans.
Yeah. Very thought-provoking. Thank you. What do we have to do to get past?
I got the key for the gate hidden in one of those objects. Break them until you find it.
Oh, we get to break stuff? Why didn't you say so?
Okay. So, in this yard, you have to press and hold the B button to break open 5 birdhouses. Now, there, I could direct you to the one that has the key, I guess, but the problem with that is that I can't, because it's randomly spawned which one it's in. Well, it's not randomly spawned, it's Oh, I didn't mean to do that. If you ever find yourself one of these gnomes, spam the attack button until you get out. You might take only a few hits if you do it. But whichever birdhouse the key spawns in is purely dictated by what order you do them in. Like, the order I'm doing them in now is might be different from the order you do them in. It's whatever the last birdhouse that you hit has the key in it. By the way, avoid this little patch of grass right here, because as we have demonstrated with Verne, it puts you to sleep. You can break these lights too. Nothing really happens if you do, though. As I'm about to demonstrate, literally nothing's going to happen if you break these lights. Absolutely nothing comes out of them, but I like to do it anyway. I don't really know why I like to do it, but anyway, you only really need to break the birdhouses, but if you want some chips, you can break open the structure. And this is our fourth one, and then our fifth one, broken. Key drops. Grab that key. Now we can use that on the door. Alright, but first, before we do that, we're going to grab this CD up on this little structure right here, grab another cookie box coming down the stairwell, and before we move on to the next area, we're gonna make sure we have all of the collectibles. I wanted to avoid the gnome. As you can see, the radius for which you can step into that thing isn't exactly... It's very wide, as you can see. There's another cookie box up on this little porch right here, and then once you break these, you'll get a hat from this one, and a soda can from this one. Nothing else all that interesting in this area, as I can quickly demonstrate for you guys, because if you come back here, this is where the dog is. There's nothing else interesting in this area. We've gotten everything that we can get, and so let's head into the next area.
Verne, freeze!
All this fuss over us? I just don't get human priorities.
It's the sniffer. The cranky ones pay him to deal with us. Although not that well, based on the quality of these trap designs. What do you think we are, insects? Now come on, and stay low.
Alright. One of the secondary objectives is to not get hit by the laser, and the only tip I can give is just watch where you jump. Use shadows to guide where you're going to land. But you can come up here to grab a cookie box and a chip container. Another thing is don't try and engage with the rats unless you're on this porch. That's a big tip right there. Because if you try and engage with the rats on the ground, that's just going to get you killed. So use your golf swing by holding down the B button or whatever respective button is on your controller. And you should be able to take out the rats with ease because the rats don't trigger the lasers for some odd reason. And if Verne can trigger the lasers, but if he does, it's not going to count against you because obviously an AI can't count against you. Oh, hang on, I'm not ready to explain buddy attack yet. Ta-da. Come on. Oh. It's like Verne has set off the lasers, but that's okay, because it doesn't count against us. Come on. There we go. Alright, all rats down. Go and pick up the rest of the food. And, as I mentioned, chips heal you. Well, they don't heal you. Technically they heal you, because food is your health. There's a music disc, or CD, in this one, and then a cookie box in that one. And then... there's a cooler over here. This is the second of two coolers that we needed to get for our secondary objective. That's pizza gotten. And by the way, food accounts for both players. Now, for these lasers, you need to double jump in order to get over them, which the only difference from the last one is that you have to double jump. And other than that, this is the end of the level right here.
Ready, Stella?
Yeah, but this better be one stupid cat.
You can see that's our objective completed. And that is all five objectives completed for the Gladys' backyard. And so, that's going to do it for this episode of Over the Hedge. So, I would like to thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for the next episode, debuting coming out tomorrow at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, as is going to be the usual. And until next time, this has been GameMagic 13, signing off, saying I hope you have a fantastic Oracle day, and I will catch you all next time for some more Over the Hedge. Goodbye! Team.